Secretary Shultz was a foreign policy visionary who helped herald the peaceful end of the Cold War and whose legacy left us safer from the specter of the world's most dangerous weapons. What may be less well known, however, are the profound ways in which he shaped this institution. He was a champion of the women and men of the department, and it's no accident that our Foreign Service Institute bears his name. As the Secretary said yesterday, the work we do now and will do well into the future will be shaped by Secretary Shultz's legacy. We send our deepest condolences to Secretary Shultz's family and loved ones. We look forward to receiving the report and the data from the WHO investigation. Broadly speaking, we have expressed our concerns regarding the need for full transparency and access from China and the WHO, access from China and the WHO to all information regarding the earliest days of the pandemic. It's imperative that the world learns as much as possible about the earliest days of the COVID-19 pandemic so that we can understand its origins. And so importantly, we can prevent future biological catastrophes.
We've also been in close contact with our allies and partners around the world, particularly in the Indo-Pacific region, driving vigorous diplomatic outreach to help coordinate an international response to what happened. The strong and unified message emerging from the United States has been essential, in our view, to encouraging other countries to join us in pressing for immediate return to democracy. Last week, the United States helped bring together the UN Security Council, which issued a strong statement in support of Burmese democracy. And this week, we will use our renewed engagement on the Human Rights Council to strengthen the world's commitment to human rights in Burma. Today, I again call on the Burmese military to immediately release the democratic political leaders and activists. The military must relinquish power it seized and demonstrate respect for the will of the people of Burma, as expressed in their November 8th election.
Iran can never acquire a nuclear weapon. That was at the crux of the 2015 Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. It will be a guiding principle of our approach towards this challenge. If Iran resumes its full compliance with the 2015 nuclear deal, we'll do the same. We'll seek to lengthen and strengthen the provisions of that deal. We'll use it as a platform to build and to negotiate follow-on agreements to address other areas of Iran's malign activity.
On behalf of the people of the United States, I would like to echo Secretary Blinken's wishes of health, peace, and good fortune this Lunar New Year. We hope the Year of the Ox will bring great success and opportunity for all. As millions of Americans celebrate the new year, the United States stands with friends and allies to advance our shared prosperity and values, and we invite all nations to join us in building a better world for future generations. Best wishes to you and your family.